स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे इज टॉपिक मम्स। डेफिनेशंस, मम्स इन इज एन एक्यूट वायरल इन्फेक्शन ऑफ चाइल्डहुड दैट टिपिकली इन्वॉल्व स्वेलिंग ऑफ वन और बोथ पैरोटिड ग्लैंड्स, ऑल्दो मैनी डिफरेंट ऑर्गन कैन बी इन्फेक्टेड। नेक्स्ट है इटियोलॉजी ऑफ मम्स। मम्स वायरस इन कॉज ऑफ मम्स इन एन आरएनए वायरस ऑफ जीनस रेबुलो वायरस इन द पैरा माइक्सोविराइडे फैमिली विच आल्सो इंक्लूड द पैरा इन्फ्लुएंजा वायरस। ओनली वन सेरोटाइप इज नाउ। एपिडेमोलॉजी ऑफ मम्स। मम्स इज एंडेमिक इन द मोस्ट अनवैक्सीनेटेड पॉपुलेशन। द वायरस इज स्प्रेड फ्रॉम ह्यूमन रिसर्वियर बाय डायरेक्ट कॉन्टेक्ट एयरबोर्न ड्रॉपलेट्स। नेक्स्ट, फॉर्मुलेट्स कॉन्टामिनेटेड बाय सलाइवा पॉसिबल बाय यूरिन। नेक्स्ट, इट इज ए डिस्ट्रीब्यूट वर्ल्ड वाइड इफेक्ट बोथ सेक्स इक्वली। नेक्स्ट epidemiology that continue before introduction the vaccine 1967 the peak incidence of disease occurred in children 5 to 9 year of age 85% of infection occurred in children younger than 15 year of age. Now most cases occur young adults producing outbreak of colleges or in the workplace. नेक्स्ट, आउटब्रेक्स अपीयर टू द प्राइमरी रिलेटेड टू लैक ऑफ इम्यूनाइजेशन स्पेशली इन एन अंडर इम्यूनाइज कोहोर्ट ऑफ चिल्ड्रन बोर्न फ्रॉम 1967 टू 1977 रेदर देन टू वेनिंग टू इम्यूनिटी। एपिडेमिक्स अकर ऑल सीजन बट आर स्लाइटली मोर फ्रिक्वेंट इन लेट विंटर एंड स्प्रिंग। इन द यूनाइटेड स्टेट ऑफ रिपोर्टेड इंसिडेंट्स ऑफ मम्स declined after the introduce of mumps vaccines in 1967, the recommendation of the routine use in 1977. Next, after expanded recommendations of 2 doses, mumps, mumps, rubella vaccines scheduled for measles control in 1989, mump cases declined further. Viruses has been isolated from saliva long 6 days and 9 days appearance of salivary gland in swelling. Transmission does not seem to occur more than 24 hours before the appearance of the swelling and later than 3 days after it has subsided. Virus has been isolated from urine from the first and 14 days after the onset of salivary gland swelling. Next step, pathogenesis of mumps. After entry into the last of initial multi-application in the cells of respiratory tract, the virus of blood-borne many tissue, among which the salivary and other glands are the most susceptible. Clinical manifestation of the mumps. Pehla hai, the incubation period hota hai jo 40 to 24 days with a peak of 17 and 18 days. Approximate 30 to 40% infections are subclinical. Next, in children, proximal manifestations are rare but may be manifested by fever, muscular pain, headache, malaise. Typically produce the parotid swelling by 12 to 24 hours. Clinical manifestation, common complaints are headache on the side of the parotid involvement, discomfort from eating the drinking acidic food, parotid pain is the most pronounced during the first few days of swelling. The swollen parotid gland lifts the earlobe upward and outward, and the angle of the mandible is obscured. The opening of the extension duct to the buccal mucosa in endomatous and erythromatous. Thymus expands on the मस्तिष्क मसल्स कैन अकर। नेक्स्ट, द अदर सिल्वरी ग्लैंड सच एज द सब मैंडिकुलर एंड सबल्यूबल ग्लैंड मे बी आल्सो इन्वॉल्व्ड इन 10 to 15% ओनली द सब मैंडिकुलर ग्लैंड्स मे बी स्वोलन। नेक्स्ट, द प्रेसनेटल एडिमा कैन बी नोटेबल। मोरबिलीफॉर्म रैश हैज बीन रिपोर्टेड इन एसोसिएशन विद मम्स इन्फेक्शंस। नेक्स्ट, सिस्टमेटिक सिम्टम इंक्लूड फीवर यूजली रिसोल्व विद 15 to 5 days। द पीरियड स्वेलिंग सबसाइड्स विद इन 7 to 10 days। Adolescents and adults have more severe disease than young children. Diagnosis of mumps. The diagnosis of mumps parotiditis is usually apparent from the clinical symptom and physical examinations. Routine laboratory tests are non-specific. Usually, leukopenia is present, retinitis, lymphocytosis, and illuminations. In serum amylase levels common, the rise tends perennial and the parotid swelling and then the return of the normal with 2 weeks. Diagnosis me hai. Next, the microbiological diagnosis by serology of virus cultures, enzyme immunoassay for mumps immunoglobulins. Immunoglobulins and immunoglobulins G and immunoglobulin M antibodies are most commonly used of diagnosis. Immunoglobulin M antibodies are detectable in the first few days illness that are considered diagnostic. Mumps virus can be cultured from the saliva, cerebrospinal fluid, cerebral blood, urine, brain, and other infected tissue. Primary culture human monkey kidney cells are used in the viral isolation. The mumps skin test unreliable for diagnosis, mumps, and determination of susceptibility in auto infections. Differential diagnosis. The differential diagnosis by parotiditis is the broad and includes bacterial parotid duct stone, drug reactions, recurrent parotiditis of childhood, other viruses such as influenza, Coxsackievirus A, Picovirus, and parainfluenza virus 1 and 3 can cause parotiditis and are usually responsible for recurrent mumps. Parotid tumor, Sjögren's syndrome. Complication of the mumps, meningoencephalomyelitis. First, the most frequent complication of childhood, clinical manifestation occur in more than 10% of patients. The incidence of mumps, meningoencephalitis is approximate 250 and 10,000 cases. One lakh cases. Die say 1 lakh cases. The mortality rate in about 2%. Complication of meningoencephalomyelitis. Fifth, may be either primary infection of neurons, parotiditis frequency appear of the same time of flowing onset of encephalitis, post-infection encephalitis with demyelination, encephalitis follow parotiditis by an average of 10 days. Meningoencephalomyelitis is continue. Complications. Mumps meningoencephalitis is clinically indistinguishable from meningoencephalitis from other origin. Moderate stiffness of the neck is seen, but the remaining finding of the neurological examination are usually normal. Next, the cerebrospinal fluid may be show of lymphocytic pleocytosis of less than 500 cells. Although occasionally of count may be exceed 2000 cells. Complications. Orchitis and epididymitis. Pehla hai, these complications rarely occur in the pubescent. Boys are more common, 15 to 35% in adolescents in adults. The testis is most often infected with the without epididymitis. Epididymitis may be also occur alone. Bilateral orchitis occurs in approximate 30% of patients. Rarely there is a hydrocele. The orchitis usually follow parotiditis within 8 days. Orchitis may also occur without evidence of salivary and gland infections. Orchitis and encephalitis continue of complications. Next, the onset of usually abrupt with a rise of temperature, chills, headache, nausea, and lower abdominal pain. Next, the affected testis becomes tender and swollen, and the adjacent skin of edematous and red. Next, the average duration of illness in 4 days. Approximate 30 to 40% affected testis atrophy, leaving a cosmetic imbalance. Infertility is rare even in bilateral orchitis. Oporitis pelvic pain and tenderness are noted in about 7% of post-pubertal female patients. There is no evidence of impairment of fertility. Pancreatitis, mild and subclinical pancreatitis involve of common, but severe pancreatitis is rare. It may be unassociated with salivary gland manifestation, may be misdiagnosed as gastroenteritis. Next, epigastric pain and tenderness, which are suggestive, may be accompanied by fever, chills, vomiting, and progesterone. Next, the Innovent serum analyzes value of characteristic value present in patient with mumps with and without clinical manifestation of pancreatitis. Myocarditis. Serious complications of cardiac manifestation are extremely rare. The infection of the myocardium may be more common than recognized. Electrocardiographic testing. Trackings revealing changes, mostly difference in ST segment in 30% of adults in one stages. 3. Such involved may be explained the precordial pain, bradycardia, and fatigue, sometimes noted be among adolescents and adults with mumps. Arthritis, migratory polycythemia, and even arthritis are occasionally seen in adult mumps but are rare in children. The knees, ankles, shoulders, wrist are most commonly affected. The symptom lasts of few days of 3 months with a median duration of 2 weeks. Complication of thyrocarditis. It is uncommon children. Diffuse and swelling of thyroid may be occur 1 week after onset of pancreatitis. Anti-thyroid antibodies subsequently develop. Deepness of complications. Unilateral, rarely bilateral nerve deepness of may occur. The incidence low. 1/15,000 cases. Mumps was historically loading cause of unilateral nerve deafness. The hearing may be loss of transient and permanent. Complications of ocular complications. Dacryoadenitis may be occur. Painful swelling is usually bilateral and lacrimal glands. Optic neuritis. Papillaritis may be occur. Symptom may be loss within mild ballooning and recovery 10 to 20 days. Treatment of mumps. There is no specific antiviral therapy treatment. B. Anterior superative antipyretics, acetaminophen, ibuprofen, and indicated fever. Bed rest should be guided the patient needs, but no evidence indicates that the prevents complication. The diet should be adjusted to patient ability to sleep. Orchitis mica treatment should be prostituted with local support and bed rest. Mumps arthritis, the response 2 week course of a non-steroidal anti-inflammatory agent of corticosteroids. Salicylates do not appear to be affected. Prevention of mumps. Mumps vaccine is derived of Zerilin strain of mumps virus. The vaccine induces antibody 97% of seronegative recipients and less, and has 95% protective efficacy. The initial mumps immunization, usually as measles, rubella vaccine, is recommended at 12 to 15 months of age. The second immunization, also a MMR, is recommended routinely at 4 to 6 years of age, but may be administered via any during childhood, provided at least 4 weeks have elapsed since the first dose. Prevention. Next, women should be avoided becoming of the pregnant for 30 days after monovalent mumps vaccination, 3 months if vaccination was performed with rubella vaccines. Other contraindications of vaccines include allergy of vaccine component, anaphylaxis to neomycin, moderate the severe acute illness with or without fever, immunodeficiency, primary immunodeficiency is cancer, cancer therapy, long term and high dose corticosteroid therapy, severely immunocompromised including those with HIV infections. Next, recent immunoglobulin administration. Prevention of mom's next children who have not previously received the second dose should be immunized by 11 to 12 year of age. Rarely peritonitis and low grade fever can be developed 10 to 14 after vaccination. Vaccination do not shed virus. Maternal antibody to protect in the infant in the first 6 months of life. Prognosis of mumps. The prognosis of mumps in childhood is excellent. Infection usually confirms permanent immunity. Reinfection may have been documented. Then complete is topic of mumps. Thank you, everyone.